In January 2020, we entered the decisive decade, the decade where we know that falling short of our decarbonisation ambitions will trigger climate risks with irrevocable consequences for our environment, society, economy, and way of life. The start of the decade has also shown us more than ever that our task must be about adaptation and resilience, as well as mitigation. We see the impacts of a changing climate in all of our communities, from the Northern Hemisphere's warmest summer on record, to the catastrophic wildfires in Australia and the US, to devastating floods in some of our most fragile cities and islands. Climate change is more personal than ever. As we think about the vast scale of the challenge ahead, I draw optimism from growing alignment with a shared goal set through the Paris Agreement, limiting temperature increases to well below 2 degrees Celsius. The science guides our path, net zero by 2050. We can be confident that we know the best approach to reaching these targets, a strong partnership between the public and the private sectors. And governments play the most critical role when providing direction, creating frameworks that deliver investment confidence, and supporting technologies through their early stages. This enables the private sector to do what it does best, to take its signal from that direction, drive down costs, improve efficiencies, and finance change at scale. This model has served us well in the decarbonisation of electricity generation, and I'm confident it can do the same in transport, in agriculture, and in industrial processes. Macquarie's role in this is to support governments and clients to realise their decarbonisation ambitions on Paris alignment, carbon neutrality, and on net zero. We will bring all our drive, innovation and resource to support you and look to lead on new solutions to accelerate our shared journey. So let me step you through three key challenges facing us all, where I believe we're working with our clients, portfolio companies and communities to lead positive change. First, meeting the need for more renewable energy. For some time now, it's been clear that the biggest challenge in the energy transition is not the availability of capital, but the availability of projects. And the scarcity of skilled developers who can sponsor projects through the early stages, de-risking them for long-term owners. This is a skill set we have built in GIG, which we acquired 3 years ago, and which has become a key part of Macquarie's sustainable finance capability. We've grown the team with both financial and industry experience, and we've grown the development pipeline to 25 gigawatts, acting as project sponsor, utilising our balance sheet, and delivering projects with low or no public subsidy. While GIG specialises in the development and early construction stage of projects, MIRA, our fiduciary asset management business, focuses on the late construction and operation stages, where we're also managing construction and operations of a further 21 gigawatts. While these 46 gigawatts across 300 projects are mainly in established technologies of wind, solar and waste to energy, we're also working to bring new technologies to scale. Technologies like zero emissions transport infrastructure and fleets, hydrogen and utility scale storage. We're working with our partners in the Climate Finance Leadership Initiative and with local development finance institutions to reach further into developing countries, helping to address investment barriers. We all have more work to do here to meet the full opportunity for renewable in developing countries as energy demands grow. Second, strengthening the resilience of the infrastructure we rely on. MIRA is the world's largest infrastructure manager with 150 portfolio companies serving over 100 million people each day. And it aspires to be the global leader in sustainable real asset management, working on decarbonization strategies for assets across its entire portfolio. Each portfolio company faces specific climate-related physical and transition risks. As stewards of these companies, on behalf of our investors and the communities they serve, we have a duty to make sure that they are long-lasting and resilient. This builds and preserves long-term shareholder value for pensioners, insurance holders, and others who depend on MIRA for returns. On a practical level, that means working as an active, engaged manager with energy companies like Alenia in Finland, which has buried 26,000 kilometres of overhead power lines to improve resilience to climatic conditions. And also Energy Development Corporation in the Philippines, which has improved early warning systems to maintain energy supply through more extreme typhoons. Also in our agriculture business, we're working with our partners to adopt new precision farming technology to produce higher yields, cut emissions, and reduce environmental damage. And where Macquarie Capital is building new infrastructure, we're designing in climate resilience from the outset, like the Blankenberg Tunnel in the Netherlands, built with flood mitigation systems, or ensuring that new transport infrastructure is equipped with solar generation as standard to reduce energy demand. The wider area of climate resilience and adaptation has lacked the profile and momentum that it needs, and we're delighted to support our partners at the Global Centre on Adaptation in what is set to be a priority area of discussion for COP26 in Glasgow next year. Third, supporting the decarbonisation of industry. Perhaps the biggest source of optimism in recent years is the leadership shown by a growing group of business in setting ambitious climate goals. From big tech to carbon-intensive industrial processes, we are working in partnership to create tailored solutions in green power, PPAs, on-site generation, storage, smart meters, and zero-emission transport. And where clients need advisory services to raise or invest capital or acquire new assets, the world's leading renewable advisory team helps connect capital to opportunities. In our commodities and global markets business, we're working with clients to provide risk and capital solutions in natural gas and LNG markets. We know that gas has played a critical role in driving our early progress in decarbonisation and remains vital in replacing much higher carbon alternatives. A necessary companion to this activity is faster progress in complementary solutions like CCUS and hydrogen. In the past year, we've supported clients in projects like the Acorn CCUS project in the North Sea, in Canada, where we're helping develop a new green hydrogen project, and MIRA's asset Cadent, which is working to introduce hydrogen into the UK gas network. Although the transition is gathering speed, we know that the world cannot decarbonise fast enough to achieve its targets. And this means accelerating efforts to cut new emissions at the same time as removing carbon from the atmosphere. Our CGM team is a leader in voluntary carbon offsets, supporting conservation activity to protect tropical rainforests and the important work of the Task Force on Scaling Voluntary Carbon Markets. While our focus is on clients, we also look to lead in our own operations. Carbon neutral since 2010, we are reducing our resource consumption and working to power all our activities through renewable energy, producing our own where we can. With a focus on risk management, we're running off our remaining lending exposure to the coal sector, and MIRA has adopted its own coal policy, committing to no new investments in assets with a material dependency on coal. And we're also increasing transparency through our TCFD disclosures and scenario analysis to understand climate risks and opportunities. We're also improving practice on our green impact reporting, combining our green rating tools with Bloomberg New Energy Finance's project database to assess the carbon impact of over 60,000 wind and solar assets. For 51 years, we have grown our business guided by our values and our culture. Our operating principles of opportunity, accountability, and integrity are the foundation stones for a culture that continues to be restlessly optimistic and curious. Macquarie's purpose is empowering people to innovate and invest for a better future. Those words are a daily reminder of what we bring: innovation and investment, and an empowered team taking incremental steps that pull towards a better future. 2020 has been a tough year for our clients, for our own people, and for the communities we serve. The global pandemic has challenged us all to rethink how we do business. And it will take time to recover from the economic damage, but it also gives us an opportunity like no other to build back better. So while we recognise the scale of the challenge and the urgency of the task, I'm optimistic that we can turn this moment into one of opportunity. Climate change is a challenge bigger than any one of us, but not too big for all of us. We have it in us to make this decisive decade one to remember for the right reasons, and we look forward to working with you to deliver that better future.